Welcome to 1000 Why Questions. Here we dig into everyday mysteries you've always wondered about. Ever looked down at your phone halfway through the day and thought, wait, how is it already at 20%? You charged it all night, barely used it this morning, and yet it's dying again. Let's unpack why your phone battery drains so fast. It's not just you. Modern smartphones juggle dozens of invisible processes, even when you're not touching them. Think of it like leaving every light in your house on while sitting in one room. That quiet glow? It's your battery slowly disappearing. Every notification, vibration, or ding wakes your phone for a split second. Even checking the lock screen costs power. Multiply that by hundreds of micro moments each day, and it's like running a marathon in tiny steps. Some apps are worse offenders than others. Navigation, social media, and video platforms keep refreshing content, tracking your location and pulling data, even while your phone's asleep. They're basically digital insomniacs burning power all night. So before blaming your phone, realize this. It's not about usage time. It's about what your phone's doing when you think you're not using it. That's where most of your battery life quietly slips away. Now, how does that even work? Your battery is a chemical system, not just a fuel tank. Inside are lithium-ion cells moving charged particles back and forth. Each swipe, scroll, or stream speeds up those movements, slowly wearing down capacity over time. When you open a bright app or stream video, the screen's backlight becomes a power-hungry beast. Screens alone can consume more than half your battery, especially if brightness stays above 80%. That's like driving with headlights on at noon. Refresh rates add another twist. Many newer phones run at 120 Hz, meaning the display refreshes 120 times per second. It looks silky smooth, but that doubled frequency can cut battery life by 25-30%. Smooth costs juice. Temperature matters too. Batteries hate heat. At 95 degrees, a typical summer car interior, chemical reactions speed up, aging the battery faster. That's why your phone sometimes dims or slows down. It's protecting itself from cooking its own circuits. Cold does the opposite. It slows the flow of lithium ions, making your phone think it's out of energy. Ever had your phone die while skiing and revive indoors? That's science, not magic. So, in short, screen heat and hidden background activity are the top culprits. But the why behind those processes runs deeper, right into the way your phone's software manages energy. Let's dive into the science. Modern operating systems like iOS and Android use something called power scheduling. They decide which apps get energy first, kind of like air traffic control for electrons. But not all apps follow the rules, especially older or poorly optimized ones. Push notifications? They rely on wake locks. These keep the processor active, waiting for updates. Some apps abuse this system, like leaving your car idling just in case you might drive soon. Then there's location tracking. When an app constantly pings GPS satellites, it can drain 5 to 10% per hour. Even weather or map widgets checking your position quietly chew power behind the scenes. Wi-Fi and cellular signals are another big drain. When your signal's weak, your phone boosts its antenna power, up to 20x more energy use, according to a Stanford engineering study. So yes, bad signal literally burns battery. Bluetooth, 5G, and background syncing also play their part. Each feature sends out tiny hello signals to stay connected. Multiply that by hours, and you've got a constant radio chatter draining your charge. Even idle apps keep refreshing data, email syncing, calendar updates, cloud backups. These micro syncs seem harmless, but collectively consume 10 to 15% daily battery. According to a report from the University of Michigan, all of these add up to what experts call background load. It's invisible, silent, and relentless. But here's the twist. Sometimes the biggest battery drainer isn't your phone at all. It's you. Or rather, how you use your phone. Constantly unlocking scrolling social media and letting the screen glow for minutes at a time teaches your brain to crave micro hits of dopamine, and your battery pays the price. Notifications amplify that loop. Every buzz triggers a tiny stress response, making you check your phone more often. According to Harvard psychologists, that alert anxiety can increase screen time by up to 40%, indirectly killing your battery faster. Some users even charge midday just in case. But that habit heats the battery repeatedly, shortening its lifespan. Lithium cells prefer slow, steady cycles, not constant top-ups. Over time, your battery chemistry physically changes. Microscopic layers of lithium form on electrodes, trapping energy you can't use. After 500 full cycles, most phone batteries hold only about 80% of their original capacity. Manufacturers try to help with adaptive charging that slows power intake overnight. It learns your routine, say, unplugging at 7 a.m., and fills the last 20% right before you wake up. Smart, right? Still, even smart systems can't beat physics. Every charge, every scroll, every heat spike chips away at capacity. But understanding these patterns means you can fight back. Simple tweaks help. Lower brightness, disable background refresh, use dark mode, and unplug once charged. Also, avoid charging while gaming or streaming. That combo doubles heat stress. Airplane mode during low signal zones can save hours. Turning off 5G when unnecessary helps too. And if you're traveling, a small power bank beats constant outlet anxiety. Fun fact, NASA engineers deal with the same chemistry in satellites. They manage battery life by controlling temperature, voltage, and duty cycles. Basically, giving batteries rest days. You can do the same by unplugging overnight occasionally. So the next time your phone dies too soon, remember it's not betrayal, it's biology and behavior colliding. Every pixel, ping, and push notification is part of that invisible tug of war. The good news? You have more control than you think. Understanding the why behind battery drain turns frustration into strategy. If you enjoy small, everyday science like this, stay curious. Because every why hides a piece of how our world and our tech really works. We hope you enjoyed this episode of 1000 Why Questions. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share to support the channel. Got a thought or your own why question? Comment below. And if you want more,